Why do you think the medical professionals, you know, the providers, the doctors, are so against it? Do you think it's because they didn't get the education?
Absolutely. Absolutely. We got the same exact education that the public got with the propaganda. You know, until 1942, cannabis was actually in the PDR. PDR is a document or a booklet that gets sent to physicians that say, here's the medicine, here's how it's prescribed for every condition. Cannabis was in that until 1942 when it was removed, making it officially illegal. And then there's like these minimum sentencing laws for people who use cannabis. In 1951, the Boggs Act, which created minimum sentencing laws, was first used for people who are having cannabis in their possession. So it's been politicized. It's been, we have now a whole generation of almost a century now of physicians who've lost this art of medicine. And the understanding that there's not enough research, again, that's false. There's databases called PubMed, where houses all of the medical journals. You can type that word endocannabinoid in there. I did this a couple of weeks ago. 28,000 studies.
My goodness.
On average, like an estimate. So there is plenty of research. You may have to look outside the United States. Even in the United States, there is some degree of research. University of Mississippi has been doing it since the 70s. Do you know why?
No.
Because the U.S. government has two patents on marijuana showing its medical benefit.
Oh, my goodness.
It expires in January of 2021. So we will see where the nation goes with medical marijuana when the government's patent ends.